Hi, this is Dr. Mike Natter, and I'm here with BoardVitals, and I was going to answer some internal medicine questions from their question bank today. Let's get started. A 55-year-old Caucasian male presents with his wife for evaluation of spells. For the past 3 to 4 months, whenever he skips breakfast, he becomes confused and has blurry vision. The patient sometimes wakes up early and feels hungry and tremulous. He eats lunch and dinner at regular times and has not noticed these symptoms at any other time of the day. His wife, who is a nurse practitioner, adds that the last few times he had spells, she had to get him something to eat because he looked like he was about to pass out. The patient feels much better after eating. He is otherwise healthy, has no surgical history, and denies taking any medications. Physical exam shows the following: 185 pounds, 6 feet tall, blood pressure is normal, heart rate is normal. After 12-hour fast, however, the patient's lab results performed during one of his spells are as follows. Plasma glucose is 48, insulin level 3.2, C-peptide 1.2, proinsulin 21.5, beta-hydroxybutyrate 0.3, plasma glucose after glucagon injection is 87. An oral hypoglycemic screen is negative. What is the most likely diagnosis? So there's a few things to unpack here. The first thing we should look at is the question is trying to trap us. They're trying to set a garden path for us by telling us that this patient has hypoglycemia, and the first branch point is to say, is this true hypoglycemia from endogenous insulin or other causes, or can this be exogenous insulin use? Given that the stem of the question is telling us that his wife is a nurse practitioner, is leading us down this road of thinking maybe he has access to exogenous insulin and maybe something fishy is going on. So then we have to look at the labs. When we have exogenous insulin on board, we would expect no C-peptide, no proinsulin. And the values that are given to us during a spell and during a hypoglycemic state is that his insulin is actually elevated to 3.2. His C-peptide, additionally, is also elevated or within a range of showing elevation, as is the proinsulin. All of these are data to suggest that the insulin is turned on from an endogenous standpoint, meaning something is happening that his body is creating insulin in a state when he should not be. Additionally, his beta-hydroxybutyrate is 0.3. Beta-hydroxybutyrate is a measure of, basically is a ketone body, and is a measure of seeing if someone happens to be in DKA or if insulin is not there at all. So this doesn't really give us one state or another to suggest if it's exogenous or endogenous, but it is telling us that there is no ketones at this moment. Because we know that he has a negative oral hypoglycemic screen, we can also rule out other causes of exogenous use, such as sulfonylureas. So that leaves us really with one idea. This guy has something in his body that's creating endogenous insulin. Then we can take a look at the answer choices. The first answer choice is exogenous insulin use. Since we talked about the lab markers of C-peptide and proinsulin being elevated, we can say that that is likely not the case. Surreptitious sulfonylurea use is ruled out because, like we said, his oral hypoglycemic screen was negative. C is insulinoma. An insulinoma could and would produce endogenous insulin at states when he should not have insulin active. So this sounds like the correct answer. Lastly, insulin antibodies, such as GAD65, would be if there would be no insulin on board and seen mostly in states of type 1 diabetes, which would not cause hypoglycemia. So in this case, the answer should be insulinoma C. I'm Dr. Mike Natter. I hope to join me again for the next question.